Morning, sport fans. We're here in number 8's lair. Taking a look at her here. We're charging up the battery because tomorrow I think we're going fishing. But that's not what we're here today for. Today, we're here to go on catfish patrol. We're gonna take Yellow Peril up here. And if the weather clears up just a little bit more, we're gonna go out and see if we can find some bait schooled up in the river. See what's going on out there. Go outside and there's YP. YP is Yellow Peril. They were biplanes in World War II. Looked very similar to a Stearman PT-17, and they were painted yellow because they were trainers for the Navy, and they were nicknamed Yellow Peril. I guess a lot of young naval aviators found peril in the sky flying Yellow Peril. So I built this yellow biplane, and it was nicknamed Yellow Peril. But it's not really perilous. It's a pretty gentle airplane. So we just call it YP for short. Sounds a little less perilous.
Okay, sport fans. Going on catfish patrol today. Take a Yellow Peril up and go check out some of the local waters. So let's get going here. Stick back. Forward, carburetor heat off, crack the throttle, hit the wobble pump a couple of times, get some fuel pressure up to the carburetor. Okay, I'm going to turn the intercom off for a second. Okay, I'm back with you again. Okay, all temperatures coming up. All pressure is 60 pounds at idle. That's good. Got 4 pounds of fuel pressure. Plenty for idle. Zero the G meter. Not that we're going to be putting any big G's on the airplane. Bring the mixture back a little bit so we don't carbon up the spark plugs or let up the spark plugs. Wobble pumps full forward, trim set for takeoff. Okay, we're ready to taxi. Brake check. Brakes look good. S-turn this thing, unlike White Lightning, the RV, forward visibility in this thing is about nil. But that's not how we fly this airplane. We look out the side. Pretty easy. Okay, there we go. Gonna do our run-up.
Right on, I thought you were good. Hotel, 6 miles to west, descending out of 1800, setting up for 45 entry, left downwind 5, Chesapeake.
Okay, we got a Cessna coming in. He's still out there to the west of ways. We got the runway. Pattern's clear. Downwind's clear. Base is clear. We got a dove on final.
Chesapeake traffic, experimental 8272. We have Alpha's taken runway 5. We're going to be departing off of a right cross wind to the southeast. Chesapeake.
Once this buzzard is clear of the runway. Another buzzard over here. Oh, that's not a bad omen. Okay, buzzard one's clear. Buzzard two is just gonna wait around and see what happens.
Chesapeake traffic,
Cessna 3
Zero Hotels on a 3 mile, 45 to left downwind 5, Chesapeake.
Chesapeake traffic, experimental 7 Alpha is right crosswind, runway 5, departing southeast.
Intersection of the Northwest River and the Chesapeake Bypass over by Bob's Fishing Hole. There's the Northwest River. Looking down towards Tulls Bay on the Intercoastal Waterway, Currituck Sound. Let's go check out the river. See a bass boat down there. It might not be a bass boat, he's going kind of slow. He might be a catfisherman. River gets kind of dangerous. A lot of winding turns. You could be out there fishing and all of a sudden the bass boat comes around and going 80 miles an hour. Down in North Carolina right now. We just went below the line. Sky's a little milky today. Plenty of visibility for what we're doing. Nobody is on the river. Boy, these winding turns down here, those outside bends, good places to go catfishing. River, and this area up in front of us, that big bay, that's Tulls Bay. There's Tulls Creek. Got some big catfish up in there. And if there's a bait slick in that area, I'm pretty sure the fish are going to be working in there. This is Carton Sound. It's a pretty big body of water. If it was any more shallow, you could walk across it. There's some boats working up the intercoastal waterway. There's a line of them further north. Those are the snowbirds. This area down here to the right has always interested me. The chart shows 8 feet of water down there. And if you've got a southwest wind blowing up the Currituck Sound, this is the windblown bank. That body of water further over is Back Bay. They run some pretty big boats up and down this intercoastal waterway. Those little freaks. Those are all good places. Or let's just say they have their time, depending on what the catfish are doing in their seasonal migration. Those freaks can be dynamite. Down here to the right, that's Wondon's Point City Park in Virginia Beach. We're back in Virginia again. Okay, now I'm looking right up Blackwater Creek. At Blackwater Creek again. We're gonna do a turn to the left. Get back on the river. Or the creek, I should say. And as we come around, you'll see up the source of Blackwater Creek. There's the general store down there. A little boat ramp. Now, I'm not saying this is where I go fishing, but I have heard it said that Blackwater Creek fishing. And we're looking at the North Landing River now. This is the main river that these creeks dump into. There used to be a lot of barge traffic going up and down the river. And they would park their barges in these oxbows right here. I call them an oxbow, but it really doesn't have the appearance of an oxbow. I think that area was dredged for the barge traffic. It's the Pungo Ferry Bridge. And if you look up the river, you'll see a few more of those turnaround areas that were cut. Okay, folks. I think we've done enough patrolling. I've got a good idea where I'm going to be fishing tomorrow. I don't know about you. Going to work our way back to the west. We're 6 miles east of Chesapeake. I've already made my initial call. We're at 1,500 feet to the southeast, 5.5 miles. I can see it up there beside the nose. We're going to fly overhead and then go outbound to the west and join the 45-degree entry to the left downwind for runway 5. Turned out to be a pretty day. It was threatening rain this morning. It did sprinkle a little bit. That delayed our departure.
Chesapeake Comet Experimental 7 Hillet Alpha is overhead the field, 1,500 outbound to join the 45 entry left downwind runway 5. We've got the departing traffic on crosswind in sight. No backer. Chesapeake.
Seek traffic, 543 Victor departing Alpha crosswind to the northwest.
Buzzards on the runway that I can see.
72 with Alpha is cleared runway 5 at Bravo, taxiing to Hangar Road Delta, Chesapeake.
That's a nice little flight. Okay, folks, I'm going to start shutting down the radios. And I'll meet you when we shut down the airplane. Okay, folks, we just got back from our little scouting mission. Took YP down to the river and out into the sound looking for bait slicks and seeing what the water level was, if it was conducive for catfishing. And things look pretty good, so I think we're going to go out tomorrow and get out there amongst them. Hope you got a good chance to see what it was like to fly around and do a little scouting. It's a lot of fun flying that old yellow biplane. This airplane here is Ben's RP6A. It's aerobatic like YP, but I don't do a lot of aerobatics in it. It's really a slick airplane. It flies pretty fast. It'll do about 180 miles an hour. That's roughly 150 knots. And up there at 8,000 feet, it'll really get out there and stretch its legs. It'll fly roughly 500-600 miles on a trip. It gets you there pretty quick. But this is my traveling airplane. YP is my fun airplane. And number 8 is my fishing airplane. Boat, I should say. Hope you had a good time. Thanks for watching. We'll see you later.